So, kind of just quick disclaimer, nothing here is a trade recommendation. This is just for illustrative purposes and educational purposes to kind of show an example of how to think through a trade and how to use tools to sort of analyze different parameters. Don't put this trade on. It's just for educational purposes. So, sort of given that disclaimer, what I like to start with is looking at spot price. So right now I'm looking at a daily chart of Bitcoin prices going back to November all the way to today. Looking at this chart, this upward trend does not look broken at all. It looks like we're going to keep going higher. The path of least resistance is higher prices. We're sort of having a little flag pattern here right below the 50K mark. I think 50K is very psychological. The market's not showing any weakness in front of that level. So that's just kind of something to keep in mind. This is kind of a delta bias that I'm going off of at this point. So now if I'm thinking I want to structure an options position around that delta bias, I also want to get an idea of where volatility is. So when I'm on GVol, the first thing I like to do is go to the Realized Volatility tab. And one of my favorite tools is this volatility cone. So I'm looking at this volatility cone, and it's telling me basically where is realized volatility right now, which is the underlying volatility of Bitcoin itself, versus where it's been in the past. And all these data points reflect different vol windows. So whether it's one-day volatility or 30 days or 180 days, and it's looking back over the past year. And so over the past year, which was a pretty volatile year, we had March 2020, which was a crazy down move. And then we've had pretty much a lot of upside vol, a massive rally in prices starting back in the summer. So the past 6 months have been pretty volatile. So we have a very volatile year right now. And given that volatile year, the current volatility readings are pretty much above the 75th percentile across the board. I can go ahead and extend this to look back even further. So let's say I want to include January 2017 to now. So that's January 2017 was very volatile as well. You know, we had Bitcoin prices going from sub 3,000 all the way up to 20,000. Those are big moves. Those are bigger moves than 10,000 to 50,000. So just something to keep in mind. That's a big volatile year. So even given all these data points, 90-day vol is still above the upper 75th percentile. The 180 is more at the median. The 30 is above the 75th percentile. So it's just kind of a really good indication that we're in a high vol environment. And over the long run, we're going to go back towards the median, because that's what vol does, it mean reverts. So basically, my bias in volatility here is also to be short volatility. So I want to have a trade structure that's long delta, short volatility. And there's another component here. The volatility was high in 2017 because it was upside volatility. The volatility right now is high because it's upside volatility. So if that trend breaks, if prices start to head lower, we should actually see a come down in vol as well, assuming that that correlation persists. So I'm going to go ahead and look at the options market. So I want to pick out the expiration that's interesting to me. So I'm here on bit.com, and I want to see Bitcoin options expiration. So we have this March one that expires in 37 days, and then we have this June one that expires in basically 128 days. So looking at this June one, and I'm thinking, okay, I want to be short volatility. I want to be long prices. And then kind of, I also think $100,000 mark is sort of a big upper range bound. So it's going to be sort of a limit, I think, a big resistance point. So that's sort of my third assumption. So I want to be long between 60 and 100, and I want to be short vol to do that. And so the way that I would structure an interesting trade here, I would do a 1x2. 1x2s are one of my favorite structures. They're not for novice traders. They're not for people new to options. You do have open-ended risk in a 1x2. But we'll talk about how to structure around that as well. So I'm looking at this $60,000 call. It's trading 104% vol, and it's worth about $11,000. So I want to be long this $60,000 call, and I want to finance it by selling two 80 calls. So I could sell two and get paid $13,000. So assuming that I'm just paying through the market, which is sort of like the worst case execution, and we'll clean up the execution with Paradigm in a little bit here, but just assuming worst case execution, I'm paying out 11, I'm getting paid 13, so I'm net getting paid $2,000 to do that. And then I'm buying 55 deltas, and I'm selling 2 times 38, so 76 deltas. So I'm net short 21 deltas. So what I'm going to go do is I'll go ahead in the market and buy the underlying as well. I'm going to buy 21 deltas underlying for each 1x2 that I put on. So I want to start this trade to be delta neutral at the get-go. And the reason why I want to do that, because even though I have a long bias, why do I want to be delta neutral from the get-go? Well, this type of trade, as vol comes down, I'm going to pick up deltas along the way. And as time goes by, I'm going to pick up deltas along the way. So if I don't rebalance, I will naturally get more long deltas. Unless we sort of rally like crazy, then I'll have to sort of rebalance on the way up. But that's just kind of something to think about. And then if you are not holding, Bitcoin bags, if you're holding Bitcoin bags, this open-ended 1x2 trade is great because you're almost selling like a covered call on that second leg that's short because you're holding Bitcoin anyways. If you're not holding Bitcoin bags, a great way to sort of mitigate that risk and cap it off is to turn it into a broken butterfly. So you buy a 60, you sell 280s, and then you buy something like this $120,000 call. You pay $2,800 for that. So now you paid about $800 to put this trade on. And again, your profitability window here is between $60,000 and $100,000, whether you do the 1x2 or the broken butterfly. The broken butterfly just gives you some extra protection in case we rally straight to $200,000. So something crazy like that. So that's just something to think about. And then if you want to get something I like to do to kind of just get a quick and dirty back of the envelope idea of how this trade would perform as time went by or as vol went down, I can go ahead and look at like a shorter expiration and see how that performs. So just to kind of give you a quick idea, the 1x2, if we're going to March, so let's say 100 days go by or 90 days, whatever it is, holding everything else constant, my $60,000 call would be worth $4,500. And then these two $80,000 calls, call it, that would be negative $2,700. So I'm long. I have something that's worth $4,500. I sold two that's worth $2,700 total. So now my position is worth $1,800. So assuming everything else held constant, as time went by, that position paid me $2,000, and I could get paid again by selling it for $1,800. So holding all else constant, I would make $3,800 on that. Now my deltas with time going by change as well. So 41 delta minus 2 times 16, so minus 32. So now I'm net long 9 deltas. So you sort of see how my position as time goes by or as vol comes down, I pick up deltas along the way. And so if I have this long delta bias, starting delta neutral can sort of turn into long delta as time or vol comes down. And then lastly, my maximum profit is if we, just expire exactly at $80,000. So that's sort of the trade that captures all these biases that I have. And when you're thinking of your own trading, think of all your own biases and structure an options position around those biases. What's great about options is that, it's like you can diversify your biases. You can diversify your thinking. You can diversify your thinking in terms of delta, in terms of timing, in terms of vol, sort of all these different variables and structure trade around it that captures all your different ideas of the market. So that's something I think is very great about options. And then lastly, for people who are new to vol trading, if you want to just trade options for delta, you can easily just buy or sell, one-off options, stuff like that. But if you're doing vol trading, you sort of have to isolate vol. So you have to use multiple contracts to do that, or you have to pair up your options with the underlying from the get-go in order to isolate the vol component. So that's just something to keep in mind for those newer to vol trading. Anyways, I'll pass it off over here to Mickey, and I'll take it from there.
Thanks, Greg. So looking at the June fly example you discussed, I'm going to walk through how to easily build, receive pricing, and execute all legs with one single click on Paradigm. First, I want to welcome those new to Paradigm. I'm happy to introduce you to our main trade screen that you see here. To start the process of building the said fly, I'll first click the blue RFQ or Request for Quote button. Next, we'll get this nice pop-up window to fill in the structure details. I'll set it to bit.com, BTC options, and simply choose call fly from the available structures. The builder auto-populates the fly's three legs, and all we have to fill in are the structure details. So from your analysis, I will set the expiry to June and select the 60,000, 80,000, and 120,000 strikes for each leg. For this example, I'm going to say we want to put this fly on 50 times, so I'll just input that quantity here. I wanted to request pricing from all the liquidity providers, so I make that selection and click send. Maker price responses are automated, so I instantly get a bid and an offer on the net premium of this spread. As more and better prices come in, the best bid and offer will update accordingly. Once I see the price that looks attractive, all I have to do is click buy, as Greg mentioned in his commentary, and as a single package, I executed all three legs of the fly structure. At the same time, I also see the notifications on my bit.com side, and it automatically hits my bit.com account. To see more granularity, I can go into my bit.com trade history, or on Paradigm, I look at the details of the trade confirmation. Here we can see I bought the 60,000 and 120,000 calls for selling the 80,000 calls, as Greg discussed earlier. Thank you everyone for watching. Both Genesis Vol and Paradigm are excited to share this power combination of our products side by side for you. Feel free to check out Genesis Volatility at gvol.io for more option analytic tools and discover potential trading opportunities of your own. And don't forget to head to paradigm.co to get access to our automated block trading application for all your trading structures and executions. Thank you again and happy trading.